Hey everybody, welcome back to Northernlion Plays of Binding of Isaac AFTERBIRTH. Plus, we got one cool week, one of the coolest weeks of wins under our belt. Look at that. Look, this is a pretty good start. AZ3D2ZEF. Very decent damage attributes. What the heck? We were locked in heated battle there. Also, Book of Sin, pretty good. 9 Volt, very good. Works well with Book of Sin right out of the gate. And then, you know, whatever bonuses we can get on top of that. Even better. Might as well pick these up. It is still Sunday. Still having a good time. But really nothing has changed since the last episode. I mean, we went straight into it. Sundays are a busy day. I have a lot of momentum. I'm a big believer in momentum. I believe in consistency for sure. You know, whenever somebody tells me, like, they get really into something, they're like... It happens now and then with programming. Like, when I talked about programming a lot, occasionally, people would be like, I'm getting into it too. And you're like, that's really cool. And it is. But then they'd... You know, day one, they'd be like, I'm learning about data types. And you're like, that's sick. And then day 10, they'd be like, what's the right full stack to do for this kind of app? And I'm like, whoa, buddy. And they're like, yeah, I've been studying 15 hours a day. And I'm like, look, I'm not going to tell you to slow down. Because while you got the passion, I think burning that midnight oil is intelligent. You know why? I mean, here's the thing. If you got that passion, there's nothing else you'd rather be doing, right? So it's like, that's your leisure time and it's productive. It's a win-win. However, I do sometimes, I'm like, you know, maybe if you could carry some of that energy over into the next day, you'd probably be pretty stoked. Because then sometimes you're like, hey, how's that app going? And they're like, yeah, I gave up. I was going really, really hard and it was a lot of fun. And then I hit the first obstacle and I went, I think I'm just going to play League. Which is also, you know, again, if you already, you're doing things you want to do in your life, you don't have to spend every waking second, you know, in the pursuit of raising your ability to generate capital. Unless that's your thing. You're one of those, like, startup guys. No bombs. That's unfortunate. We got one last tinted rock I'd really like to interface with. But, yeah, I'm a big fan of striking while the iron's hot, but also a big fan of consistency. You can get them both. Like Austin Powers said, it's a very groovy combination, baby, yeah. Lifestyles of the Rich and... It is more of a Robin Leach impression than anything else. It's not really Austin Powers. It's much more of like, fast cars, big stars, mahogany bars. Welcome to Lifestyles of the Rich and Famous. He doesn't really talk like this either. Look, here's the thing. If we're going to be making enemies, we might as well start early. I understand that if you're from England and somebody does an English accent and they call it an English accent, you have an obligation to say there's no such thing as an English accent. But I will say, I've heard all of you, every single one of you, do an American accent, and every single time, it is one of these two accents. Yeehaw, partner! Can't wait for y'all to come down to my cheeseburger farm! Or alternatively, hey, I'm walking here. So if you're gonna, look, those in glass houses should not throw stones. That's all I'm saying. Now, when people make fun of the Canadian accent, I don't have a leg to stand on. There really is only one accent agreed upon as Canadian. There's also like a French Canadian accent for sure, but I would not, I mean, it's a prickly subject. I'm not looping it in because of the fact that they're like less Canadian. That's not the case. I'm not looping it in because of the fact that it's a bit of a... It's a culturally disparate choice, you know? I think that it deserves more respect than merely being treated under the subcategory of Canadian accents, is what I'm trying to say. But there really is only one Canadian accent, and I'll acknowledge that it's a little bit like... Bud, the Flames game was a real gong show! Yeah, Bud and I got a whole 2-4, killed it before the game. Didn't even make it to the first intermission, freaking Kachuk. Anyway, I mean, it's easy enough to do because I am it, but... Buddy called me about the host. Freaking carburetor's acting up again, you know? So I put on my bunny hug. Was just about to go mudding, right? And I get to Buddy's place. And he says, oh, don't worry about it. I just didn't pay the hydro bill. Sorry. I got lost in the sauce temporarily. There is somebody that does Canadian translations, so I just gave them a lot of work. But I hope they have some fun with it. What is a bunny hug? A bunny hug is what a Saskatchewan resident calls a hoodie. That's not a joke, but it is funny. What is a garburator? It is a garbage disposal, like in your sink that you turn on and it goes, it cuts up your garbage. What's hydro? Hydro is what people in parts of the country refer to as like their electricity bill, because it's mostly generated by hydroelectric dams. I don't know if I missed anything else. Mudden? Mudden is not a Canadian thing. It's, you know, you get in your 4x4 or your ATV or your four-wheeler, and then you go out and you just get dirty on some back roads. Put a little mud on the tires like Dierks Bentley. Put a little mud on the tires like Dierks Bentley. At the end of the day, I do have to acknowledge that the Out for a Rip video, though I've heard it so many times as to be irritating, it really was a very good approximation of Canadian townie life and diction, for that matter. Ooh, let's go. Alright, here's where we had the slightest amount of strife on our last run. It would be amazing if you just gave me this one for free. If you just gave me a little mom's knife, might even have time to sneak in a quick dobble before streaming Deadly Premonition, you know? I guess Letterkenny is almost more of a Canadian touchstone these days. People always think I'm doing like a Letterkenny bit when I say that. It's not a Letterkenny bit, it's just conjuring the accents of the people I lived next to from ages 7 until 14. Well, it was the right thing to do to come in here. We did skip our deal with the devil. Cambion Conception I actually think is a really, really good deal with the devil item. But it's not for us. It's situational just because you need some HP. And we don't have the HP to make it tick, so we will not make it tick. This is booger tiers are really nice. We got great utility on this run right now. Between 9-volt Book of Sin, like, this is really solid stuff. This one's got all the abilities to come out with a dub. There's no doubt about that. What's my plan for the rest of the day? It's a great question. Certainly, I mean, Deadly Premonition's next up. However, Deadly Premonition 2, I should say. You'll ruin my streak. Get out of here. However, the rest of the day, definitely today's a day to knock out some Northernlion tries. And I gotta tell you, look, Malph and I talked about this in a recent Super Mega Baseball episode, so I don't want to be a hypocrite here. I don't think that for having a good idea but not executing it, you should get really any credit at all. But I have, I'm hoping that it's safe to reveal that I have beaten Monster Train, come on. That I have beaten Monster Train and will be looking for something to fill that time slot. I'm hoping this week, and if it happened, you'll have already seen some episodes of it. I'm hoping this week to maybe get, one person together, but different people multiple times, and maybe do a little Monster Train multiplayer. Like a little, I know I could do some Monster Train multiplayer with Malph and with Apollo and... Simvicta's been playing. There's some other people on Twitch that have been playing. Like, Justin's been playing a little bit of Monster Train. It's always hard, though. We've talked about this before. It's really more of, like, a check-the-wire topic. Malph's kind of a different story, because he's... And Dan as well, because they straddle the line between YouTube and Twitch. But, you know, a lot of the other guys are pretty much Twitch-exclusive. So I feel weird, because everybody that I know on Twitch, for the most part, is overworked. You know, they, particularly, like, if I'm using Justin as a case study, which I have not asked his permission for, but there are times when he'll make a tweet that's like, on this week, I was live for, like, 93 hours. And I'm like, that's insane. That's way too much. That's, like, 13 hours a day. So I feel weird sometimes, even if they would be down with it. And the same goes for Apollo for sure, but I feel a little weird being like, hey, do you want to take time out from like your job to do this favor for me? That'll be fun, but also, you know, you could just be doing your own work instead. I think if you're another YouTuber, it kind of like, it moves the needle. Like it's a little cross promotion and maybe you could even record it yourself and put it up. But if you're just on Twitch, you're like, well, it's still promotion, I guess, but it's not, you know, you're not really like, maybe it's worth a little bit less. Let me put it that way. Plus, I think doing promotions sometimes with me. Hold on. Let me see what we got here. Terrible rate of fire change. That's really bad. But I stand by this as getting us closer to spun. But what I was going to say is sometimes I feel like it's a bit thankless. Let me rephrase. I was going to say it's a bit thankless to do collaborations with me. Because I like to dominate the conversation. And, I try to create space for banter and dialogue. But sometimes I just railroad what I want to do. But it's not thankless. If anything, I'm very prone to genuflection. You studying for your SATs? The SATs won't let me be, or let me be me with the ACTs. It's the ACTs because I'm in the Northeast and it feels so empty with the na 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 na. Okay, this run desperately requires a little bit of extra offensive potency. But anyway, that's my plan. I will start getting the wheels in motion. Ask people how they feel about maybe doing a little Monster Train Hell Rush sort of situation. Because, like, I'm recording enough, don't get me wrong. Like, you might think, like, what's replacing Monster Train? Well, here's what's replaced Monster Train in the past 2 weeks. A baseball episode every single day, and a Trackmania Track of the Day episode every single day, and oh yeah, Monster Train's still going. So it's not like we desperately need something for that time slot. If anything, we've been kind of burning it a little too hard, and eventually we're gonna have to pull back, but that's kind of where I'm at right now, is it's a relatively seamless... Oh, that was huge. It's a relatively seamless transition to doing a little multiplayer. Not to mention the multiplayer stuff for Monster Train. I mean, if you play Hell Rush, it's like shorter, right? The maximum time for a run is like 36 minutes or something. Who would have thought Pin would die second here? Okay. I like you. That's why I'm going to kill you last. Remember when I said I was going to kill you last? I lied. Haha. Who am I? Nope, not Arnold Schwarzenegger. I am my uncle doing an impression of Arnold Schwarzenegger. Fooled ya. Okay. Hey, picking up Incubus is a huge improvement for us. And then Book of the Dead versus Book of Sin? Yeah, I do think it's better. Certainly, I mean, if we're going for maximum wind potential, not wind potential, that's the name of Malf's new probiotic diet coming this fall to bookstores nationwide. If we want to maximize our wind potential, we need Book of Revelations, Satanic Bible, etc. Something along those lines. Because we are like, we're still really weak. I've come to accept it, but it is the honest to goodness truth. Like, this is a little maddening. Where we have? We got 8 keys. 8 keys, I'll open this. Definitely do not get hit. Your ability to succeed is largely going to be determined by deals with the devil, which we can barely afford right now. At the best of times. It was the best of times. It was the blurst of times. Okay, get me out of here. We could donate for a chance at a luck upgrade. I don't think that's what we're... It's not a high priority target right now. I can't believe we didn't kill that spider earlier. Those are good hits. Those are good hits. I love this run. Straight up. I hate our rate of fire, which is a self-inflicted wound. But I love booger tears. I think booger tears are amazing. Genuinely one of my favorite items in the game. Obviously, of course, would be much improved if we could actually pick up, you know, a fire rate increase. But still, like, what? This... We didn't get anything for Book of the Dead on that one? I think that we're on the verge of cracking this nut wide open. Where be your nutcracker? Okay, I mean, this is insanely good. I honestly think, like, most of the time with our Fallen, or with the Fallen, we'd probably look at our damage output and be like, this is spicy. But I think having high speed against the Fallen pretty much just guarantees the ability to only get hit one time. I boxed myself in there. I let myself get stuck in the Pac-Man maze. All right, very nice. A nice defensive item that is genuinely helpful. And then, truth be told, we got to go to the shop. But truth be told, I'm not going to pick up Gimpy. And I think it's tough because Gimpy is insanely useful in some situations. But I think we're saving... let me put it this way. I think the high percentage play is you do take Gimpy. But I think defensively, we're actually in a great spot right now. And I might rather just have the HP... the HP that we would have spent on the deal with the devil. And use it instead to move the needle for us here. I mean, this is probably better. It's a more expensive way to enable it, but... And PhD is really nice. Well, when you have the capacity here, obviously. Any chance? Oh, we don't have any bombs. Okay. We're gonna do the little things wrong here. Although, hold on. Hold the front door, dude. Dude, hold the front door. What do you got for me here? Where did all my money go? I kind of wanted to buy the playing card after all that. Because a two of diamonds would have been sick nasty for us, but it's fine. We're okay. All right, so I think we'll enter here, grab the money, get out of town. Obviously, this is not the card we want long term. That might be debatable, actually. I mean, I don't know. I think Robo Baby is kind of like the better choice in some ways. I think Robo Baby is going to give you like a 5 or 10% damage boost overall. I think Hallowed Ground, if we can swing it, is going to be a little bit better on long boss fights, which is really where a lot of my frustration lies on these low damage runs. But I don't feel bad about this one right now. We did get a deal with the devil on the last floor. Blank card chariot? Yeah, it's better. It's definitely better. And I mean, being able to use that once every three rooms is real nice. I don't know, I just like that with the blank card. Like, the game changes. Like, most of the time, if we got a chariot card, we wouldn't even comment on it. You know, I'd be in the middle of talking about how yellow mustard is underrated. This time, it completely changes the timbre of the game. Good, that's, you sacrifice a key to the key gods on occasion. It's just good sense. I will say, if you're gonna have me go off, then I'm gonna go off, okay? This is why you're watching the video, presumably. I do think that yellow mustard is an underrated condiment. I think because it is so commonplace, there is a little bit of, like, an inherent bias. That, like, oh, yellow mustard's boring. It's not even honey, or spicy, or Dijon. But when you really think about it, it's not really... Yellow mustard is not a boring flavor. It's a very strong flavor. Go ahead. You know, it's not like adding like a little bit of cracked pepper on the top of your dish, you know? Like, yellow mustard is it's a sizable difference in the flavor profile. It's acidic, it's a little sour, it's tangy. And yet people treat it as if like, oh, yellow mustard? Ha ha ha. I remember what life was like when I was in elementary school. Now I have a college degree. I use Dijon mustard. Or spicy mustard. Ooh la la. Don't get me wrong. No. I like or love all mustards. Not equally, but all mustards for sure. I love a spicy. I love a Dijon. I love an English. I love a Keen's hot mustard. I love it all. In fact, I'll tell you, I think my least favorite mustard is honey. I still like it. And I'll still choose it in some situations. But I would rather, in many situations, take a default, quote-unquote default, yellow mustard over a honey mustard. Straight up. But I think yellow mustard is an underrated condiment because of its ubiquity. I think there is a bias or fallacy that, you know, variations of foods are always going to be better than the original. And I, honestly, I don't stand by it. I don't stand by it. Okay, we might as well. Bob's Curse. Honestly, it's not a great pickup, but it's okay. Our other option with the Chariot card is to just go play the arcade over and over. I don't think it's a terrible idea. But I definitely do not think it's a necessary part of the win. Because even, like, getting a blood bag doesn't really mean that much. But what is this? Tammy's head? It's actually pretty bad. I think we made the right decision. Whoops. Make sure you get this before they die. I think we made the right decision by taking blank card. Sure, like, looks a little spicy, maybe. I think, like, the real problem with this run is just that we got that tears downgrade from experimental treatment, and we haven't gotten spun to compensate for it yet. But one of these days, 67% chance of a deal with the devil. More than enough ability to take a deal with the devil. Just a bit of a long fight. It's like life goes on, but like it's just a little bit of a long fight. Like if Monstro 2 is taking you this long, this is where you start to go like, you know what? What's happening? You're not even like a real enemy. You're just sort of like a time filler. You took a minute out of my life for that? Come on, man. Come on, Jack. So I think the time is ripe. Is that how you say that? We're taking a bold play here. And it completely worked in what I would describe as a demonstrably unfair way. But yes, we did just get the Hierophant card to replace the Chariot. Pretty exciting. And the Sun, for that matter. So I think you would probably... Ooh, what do we got here? Mystery Sack. Nothing wrong with that. I think on average... I mean, this is incredibly good luck. I think these pair super nicely. You use the Sun when you enter a floor to make it clear where you're supposed to... Just good damage. It's just impatience, I'll admit. But so you use the Sun immediately. Now that we know where we're going, we use the Hierophant to get us there. And I'm gonna bless you. I'm gonna own up to this 100%. It's not like I want to put in a rush job to rush. I want... Oh, my. Lanta. It's okay. With Tarot Cloth, there's nothing to worry about here. But I want to put in a rush job just because, like, taking 45 seconds to kill Chubb to get 3 cents, I don't think is high on our list of priorities right now. We already have, like, the ideal... More or less the ideal setup here, as far as items go. Technology 2, I don't know, I would probably say this is an improvement for the piercing shot ability, but obviously it does come with the a damage downgrade, which is truly terrible, but it's okay. Make sure you're using the Hierophant as often as is conceivable. I really feel like technology 2 is a bonus. Now, is it as much of a bonus as some other items? No, it's just kind of, admittedly, just kind of moving the needle ever so slightly, as you can tell. I mean, 2.68 damage is one of those times where you're like, get me out. And then when the shop, when you got a 300 million net worth, and then the shop is like, no, that's a little frustrating as well. But you know what? Say it with me. It is what it is. It's a lesson in patience for us to get out of the situation we're in right now. Do not take that damage. That is a lesson in impatience. That's what you did right there, is have a lesson in impatience. Now, it's going to be essentially impossible for us to speed up this fight, so you might as well just get cozy. That's me talking to myself, by the way. Occasionally, we'll be able to hit a body part at the same time we hit the foot, but not commonly. Oh, and then we just blew up our own tiers upgrade. Suboptimal. So just settle in. It's Blue Mom. Honestly, like, having anemia, kind of helpful here. It's things your doctor won't tell you. There you go. Thank you. And you know what? Leprosy actually is an orbital. Allows us to do some damage. Isaac, by the way. Okay, thank the Lord. Terrible floor for... No, never mind. Not a terrible floor for a deal with the devil. Feel like a lump of coal would be very nice. Should not have used my bombs here, but it's a lump of coal. All right, get me out of here. We're going to figure this one out. You doing okay? She looked at me like... She wasn't anticipating the question.
The sun.
All right. Now here, we don't have a lot of bombs, but this is still, the large rooms are rooms that ideally we would stay away from. But I feel like Tech 2, Lump of Coal, is kind of getting it done for us. Oh no, I'm trapped in here. It's kind of getting it done for us right now. Am I insane for suggesting that? Like, I feel like being able to have infinite range... Like, this is so much more damage than I would have expected out of this. Did I accidentally get one of the best synergies in the game and then forget that it's one of the best synergies in the game? Well, no. I mean, I'm realizing now... Still not exactly going up against, you know, the strongest... enemies is kind of unfair to suggest that we have such, unbelievably high damage, but it's definitely better. Now, why leave the Black Rune? Honestly, it's going to be the most controversial of controversial opinions. I feel like, historically speaking, the Black Rune doesn't end up being that useful for us in the late game. And I'm really at this point thinking that there's no way it's as useful as being able to know where we're going and having infinite HP. Like, we already have two things that give you the win. I just don't want to invite a loss into my life by being a little too cheeky. So and you know what? The bombs are very, very nice. Bombs are very, very nice here. A real orbital, also very, very nice. Now, if we could beat the odds, get a deal with the devil with some actual damage output, this one would all come into place. No such luck, but that's fine. All right. The progress is being made. We will immediately pop this and realize that we are going the wrong way, and that's fine. Oh, you almost got me on that. You almost got me on that one, you sneaky so-and-so. Now, what would be smooth with the speed, dude? What would be extremely nice is to be at full HP so that we could use the sun for more damage. You might take that as greed, and I guess a dictionary definition of the word. It's probably a little greedy considering where we're at. But I would like to say we have an 18 rate of fire and 2.68 damage on the womb too. So I kind of like, you know, your opinions on greed don't matter to me. I'm just trying to keep things stable and steady here. Seems good. You know what? Just get that out of the way right now. There you go. We got 3 bombs. This is not the right room to skip. No. You gotta play your cards right. This is not the right room to skip. With 3 bombs, I would say definitely right now, skipping a room on the cathedral is gonna be worth more than just saving us a little time, I think. We might as well. Okay, that's just idiotic. I'll take full responsibility for that one. You know what? I think I actually should reconfigure my whole life in this game right now. I think... Thank you, Leprosy, for not getting me hit there, by the way. I think that our new strat is very similar to our old one, except do what you're doing right now, but with heavy, heavy aggressive orbital usage. And even take... And this is going to irritate the people that want to see a perfect run, which is completely fair. But for my own sanity... Wow, we didn't get the deal there either. For my own sanity, I feel like this is our best option. It's a good mix of guaranteeing the win and also simultaneously not losing my freaking mind. Okay, this is again the wrong way. Not a great batting average there. That's fine, though. And honestly, I would rather save our bombs to just escape. We can fly, so... It's okay. It's a crowded room. It's like that band from the 90s, Crowded House. I have no idea any of their songs, for that matter. Do they sing a hey, hey, what's going on? No, that's 4 non-blondes. Ever bother you that song is called What's Up? And at no point in the song do they say... Not much, dog, what's up with you? It's been irritating me for several years now. I mean, would it have been so hard to be like, not much? Oh my god, not much. Not much is up with me. How about you? Okay, now that I've freed myself from the shackles of society's opinion, let's not press that. I certainly feel like we are having a lot more fun with this run. Now, in the future, will experimental treatment ever become an item non grata? No, I don't believe so. Maybe an item non gratata. Don't blow up in the judgment's face, please. Now, I don't know what you could pay out with that would make me happy, but... What if you just gave me mom's knife? We could have re-rolled it, but the irony. I think we stick with what we already got here, because I know that it works. Like, it's... You might hate the fact that we're taking a lazy approach here. But really, I don't see it the way you seem to see it, straw man in my head. I see it more like, you know, this run has created quite a difficult situation for us. And we're finding a way around it. That keeps some quality of life while also maximizing our chances of succeeding. And you gotta admit, I mean, that's a masterclass right there. I can see the Facebook ads now. Bad damage on that one. I'll admit it. I'm only human. Can you believe that we have 2.68 damage? This is the best run we've ever had with this... Well, maybe not ever, but... This is one of the best runs we've ever had with this meager damage supply. It's truly terrible. Please change it for me. No. 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 Okay, dude, it spun! Okay. So you're saying there's a chance. Well, there's definitely is more than a chance. Our damage still bad, by the way, but at least we finally got that payout. And we're going the right way. Who would have thought? Not me. Alright, now it's real orbital hours. Yeah, maybe try not taking damage to spiders. Honestly, pause button is really good as well. That's what we wanted to see. But we're in, we're just in an insanely good position, I mean to say. Honestly, I feel bad about my orbital performance. Dare I say, at the risk of being the world's ultimate complainer, I feel like I'm a little fast. So it's actually harder than you might expect to orbit effectively. That was just idiocy. I'm just running tangent to danger here. I don't want to be in danger. I want to be tangent to the curve of danger. I think that we are completely fine. I would love to not be dumb, though. Like, some of the damage we're taking, I think you can make a reasonable case for it. Some of the damage we're taking, I'm like, I get it. Mock me. I deserve the mockery for this one. Keep on mocking me, baby. Keep on mocking me, baby, baby. You know Steve Miller Band? What's your favorite band named after the person in the band? Steve Miller, Jay Giles Band, Van Halen. The Beatles, of course, famously named after John and Paul Beatle. Justin Bieber. Alright, good stuff. Things looked a little spicy for a time, but actually this was a reasonably fast and yet totally secure run. And look at that. You got a problem with the way I ran this? Guess what? We finished at full HP. For now, thanks for watching. Hope you guys enjoyed it. And I'll see you next time.
See ya!